watery grave, and afterwards we'll have a talk with him.
Well, first of all, you can taste, but the taste consists of troubles, misery, and hardships. You can come to know about the hardship of the refugees due to, just because of reading this book. You will come to know about the feelings and strong emotions of the refugees. It's not a mere poetry based on love, no. There are really very strong and touching feelings. So now I'm going to read my poems. Now I'm going to read out my second poem, what again. When we were coming from Italy to Greece, so we were coming in a boat, fishing boat. So then, during our sea voyage, we were in the grip of a sea storm. So I have written a poem about that incident. Watery grave. In day, very smooth was the journey. But in the evening, it became stormy. All those on board lost their charm, as we were in the grip of a storm. The angriness of the sea was yet extreme. We could do nothing, but everyone had to scream. Our sea voyage was in danger, as the sea was increasing its anger. Like mountains, the waves were very high. By looking at them, we held our sight. Our boat was fighting with the water, falling with valleys and rising with hills. We were busy with prayers, while some others were experiencing different spells. Invisible was the ground, as water was all around. The sea was playing with us, being very proud, and it was also shouting at us very loud. Today you will face your death. I won't let you take any more breath. There is no one to save your life, even with cannons, even with knives. I will peel off your skins. There is no one to help if you will call your kins. Today everyone has to die. You cannot escape from the waves so high. I need your blood for quenching my thirst. You won't get your death, but that too would be the worst. You will be swallowed, there is no one to save. For you, I have prepared a watery grave. It really doubled the pain when the sky started spitting the rain. We were semi-paralyzed and had lost our senses. Helpless were all, the poor, the princes. The sea was saying while flying into rage, today you can do nothing while tied in my cage. I have drowned the Titanic, which was considered to be the most powerful ship. But it could do nothing when it came in my mercy grip. Don't beg for mercy, as I won't pay any heed. I am a stone hearted and a stone doesn't bleed. Mercilessly the waves were throwing our boat with the intention to cut everyone's throat. We also burned the fire for somebody's help to take us out of quagmire. Some fell fainted due to the fright. They couldn't remember that their hearts had ever enjoyed delight. There was horror and there was terror. Everyone was shaking and trembling with fear. On the boat, we were round about 263, and all were going to drown in the sea. In a miserable condition, we knelt down to the God of the gods. Shower your blessing, O Lord of the lords. There are fathers, there are brothers, and there are the apple of eye of the mother. There are women and children too. All we need your help, all we are begging to you. We invoked the blessing of God upon the sea. He became very hard. Our Lord was addressing the sea storm, that without his consent, no one you can harm. I am the creator, you cannot rebel. Otherwise, I will teach you a lesson, and that too very well. I am Lord of the Lords when something I say. then who can refuse not to obey? You will kill, but not more than 22. You ought to obey. This is my order to you. In good health would be the rest. You cannot even scratch them if you try your best. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. I would like to invite the table.
And you were talking about this particular. So when I came to election, to the refugee camp, so then I was told by one of the assistants, and she is present here deep. She told me that there was a poetry club.
And you so immediately wanted to join them?
Exactly, because of myself I was pushed.
Yeah.
And through my journey, I didn't find even a book to read it.
Mm-hmm.
So it was really a source of great enjoyment for me. When she told me that there was a poetry club, so it was a great joy for me. And then I became one of the active members of that club. Otherwise, this is my pen. So for me, this is a classroom course, this is the canon. I will fight against the wrongdoers, the fundamentalists.
Have you experimented perhaps with other forms by hearing poetry from someone else, doing it in a different way, or do you stick to the way you used to write it?
Definitely.
Like in Pakistan as well.
Yeah, actually, I used to do poetry in Pakistan in Pashto language.
Right.
Because by that time, yeah. Pashtun. So I had never thought to do poetry in English because there was no need to do it. But when I came here to refugee center, Hosarin, so then they told me about the poetry club. So then they told me that, okay, they will translate first to into English. So then I thought that if there is translation, so I think then it loses the originality. So then I thought, why not to write in English? Because, okay, with the bliss of word, I can write it. So then for the first time, I write it in English language.
Yes.
So it was good experience for me. But just because of the credit goes to Mr. Jim and Lee Bill. Just because of them, I have written something in English. I don't say that these are really very good. But whatever I have written, so just because of them, I have written something in English.
Yeah.
So it is the first experience for me. So now it depends on you people. That either it's good or bad, I don't know.
Have you experimented perhaps with other forms by hearing poetry from someone else, doing it in a different way, or do you stick to the way you used to write it?
Definitely.
Like in Pakistan as well.
Yeah, actually, I used to do poetry in Pakistan in Pashto language.
Right.
Because by that time, Pashtun. So I had never thought to do poetry in English because there was no need to do it. But when I came here to refugee center, Hosarin, so then they told me about the poetry club. So then they told me that, okay, they will translate first to into English. So then I thought that if there is translation, so I think then it loses the originality. So then I thought, why not to write in English? Because, okay, with the bliss of word, I can write it. So then for the first time, I write it in English language.
Yes.
So it was good experience for me. But just because of the credit goes to Mr. Jim and Lee Bill. Just because of them, I have written something in English. I don't say that these are really very good, but whatever I have written, so just because of them, I have written something in English. So it is the first experience for me. So now it depends on you people. That either it's good or bad. I don't know. I've just tried.